And so
I love playing sports. I love watching sports. So I'm going to give you the highlight package. So to start with, I was born in Kolkata, India. And my dad was actually in Seattle getting his master's and was offered, who knows what, but some kind of position in Grand Prairie, of all places. So he went to Grand Prairie. And so my mother, my sister, and I met him from India in Grand Prairie in the middle of winter. So is there a life lesson to learn there? If you ever go anywhere in northern Alberta in the middle of winter, bundle up. It's cold. So we go to the next highlight, which is into Edmonton, where I'm going to high school at Strathcona Composite High. And you know, you always heard your parents talk about who you hang around with and how important that is and being careful of who you're with. Well, I'm here to tell you I'm living proof, because I got to high school and I basically, in grade 10, failed everything, was kicked out of everything, got no credit for anything, and also at the same time destroyed my athletic career. Now, they kicked all my friends out of the school and they kept me because I came to the school as the top athlete and top honor student. So they thought there's got to be some potential to keep him around. Well, what did I find out from that? I found out that you can do high school in 2 years. So I graduated, or I finished high school, and went on from there. Now, is there a life lesson to be learned there? Your parents aren't as dumb as you think, and you don't know as much as you think you know. Jump forward with me to Ticketmaster. I'm working at Ticketmaster as a programmer and as the director of operations. And at that time, the internet is in its infancy. And we started to develop the internet presence for Ticketmaster and to do online transactions, all the things we take for granted now. We developed all of that. And we did all the work out of the office, and my boss, the general manager, said to me one day, "Hey, you know, you guys are spending all this time on this internet thing. Do you think it's actually gonna go anywhere?" Well, is there a life lesson to be learned there? There sure is. Be future and visionary minded. Now, let me jump forward to the next highlight. The first date with this girl named Kim. We sat down for dinner and she looked at me and she said, "I want you to know something. I have some questions for you. And I want you to know that if you don't get these questions right, I'm never gonna see you again and we are never gonna date." She said, "Because I am not gonna waste my time with the wrong guy." So here's the thing. They weren't easy questions. They were like, "Where do you see yourself in 5 years? Where do you see yourself in 10 years? What's your vision for your life? How many kids do you wanna have? What's your relationship like with your family?" And so I answered all of the questions. And how did that go? Well, we officially started dating a few months later on a Tuesday. I proposed 3 days later. We got married 4 months later. 15 years later, my daughter was born. And 20 years later today, we are here in BC, living here in BC and loving life. And the reason we moved here, I was in a position in senior management. And you work it out when you're just the two of you, right? The busyness of the schedule and life and everything else. But once our daughter came along, things got a little bit different. And I found out that at the end of the day, no one cares about you and your family like you and your family. And so we made a decision. I remember talking to my wife and saying, "You know, honey, if I'm not involved in her life when she's 3, 4, and 5, she's not gonna want me involved in her life when she's 18, 19, and 20. And she doesn't care that I'm not here in the evenings because I'm on a project over here or something came up here or there or whatever the case might be." And so I quit my job. We gave away everything that we had because we were moving from Alberta. We gave away everything that we had and we moved out here. And so since then, I am a realtor. In my spare time, I do some personal training because I'm also a certified personal trainer. And you know what? Life is an adventure. And I close with this. Life is an adventure, but you have to make it one.